Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are on the face of the globe. Is this God not wonderful? Some people are in the morning, some are in the afternoon, some are at night, some are sleeping. Wow, this God is a good God. Do you know something? I just learned something recently. The Bible says our God neither sleeps nor slumbers. And sometimes you don't really understand what that means. But I just come to realize that, you see, when some people are sleeping, some people are awake. When some are awake, some are asleep. And God has to be there for everyone. So how does he sleep? When you are awake, he's awake. When you are sleeping, another seven people are awake. He's also awake. We serve a wonderful God. I just love this God. And I'm sure you love him too. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank God for the privilege of life. We are still trying to encourage ourselves concerning doing something monumental before the year ends. And I want to thank God for the testimonies coming in as a result of this encouragement. Today, let's go a little bit further. I have another interesting story for you. And this is the story about Gideon. God also chose Gideon to go and deliver Israel from the hand of the Midianites. So he needed to pursue the kings of Midian. And God told him, gather 300 men and pursue him, chase him away, because in the wickedness of the wicked must perish. And look at what happened. They started, chasing the enemy. And then something happened that I want you to look at. Judges chapter 8, verse 4. The Bible says, and Gideon came to Jordan and passed over, he and the 300 men that were with him, fainting, yet pursuing them. Wow. Fainting, yet pursuing. Is this not amazing? Exhausted, yet they continue to chase the enemy. What does that mean? Don't ever give up. That's what it means. That's what God is saying. Oh, maybe when I started charging us, we started pursuing something and you hit a bottleneck and you're like, no, let me just take it easy. No, don't give up. You cannot afford to give in to exhaustion. You can't afford to give in to tiredness. You have to keep moving. Look, these men were pursuing the enemies. They were tired. They said, look, we are not going to stop until we achieve our goals. Hallelujah. It is not over until you win. It's not over. No. You can't give in. You can't give up. You have to win. It's compulsory. You must win because you are a winner. They say quitters never win and winners never quit. Remember the story of Saul? He was looking for his father's asses, lost asses. That was the goal. That was the assignment. He went up and down from north to south, east to west. He didn't find them. No trace. He got tired. He said, I'm going back home. I can't continue to labor up and down. I've done everything I can do. I can't find these asses. Thank God for his servant. And I'm standing like that servant today. The servant said, my uncle, sir, we are not going back. We must not go back to tell our father that we didn't get these lost asses. I know a man of God that can help us. Let's go and meet him. He gave him another option. He said, let's try more. Let's try other options. This story is in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 6. So let us go to the prophet. Saul said, I don't even have anything to go with. He said, don't worry, I have something. See, there's always a way out in every situation. And by the time they got to the prophet, everything about Saul changed. The lost asses were found. He was anointed a king. He moved to his next level and he became a changed man. Why? Because somebody encouraged him not to give up. I'm encouraging you today. Do not give up. You may be fainting. I'm not saying you are not fainting. I'm not saying that you are not tired. I'm not saying that you have not hit the bricks wall. But keep moving. Keep pursuing. Gideon and his men pursued and they got victory. Saul continued and he became a man of a higher level. You too will get to your next level as you continue and not give up. Don't worry about whatever challenges you face. Challenges must come. If challenges do not come, what will they be doing? That's their job. They are meant to come and challenge us. We are meant to push through and make it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This year will end with your testimony. You will blossom this year and you have beauty all around you instead of your ashes in the name of Jesus. For you, for everything that pertains to you, in Jesus' name. God bless you. I'll come your way again and I'll be glad to hear your testimony. Don't forget to email me. I'd like to share your testimony and maybe share your prayer request with me as well. God bless you. I love you. I love you. I love you. And I know God loves you more. Bye.